In this video, we will be introducing standard costs and exploring how to compute material and labor cost variances. Standard costs are predetermined budgeted costs that a company can use to compare actual costs to. For example, let's say that a company spent $10,000 on direct materials this month, but the budgeted standard amount is only $9,000. This is a $1,000 unfavorable direct material cost variance. It's unfavorable because the actual cost of materials exceeds the budget. Oftentimes, we can investigate cost variances to determine what caused the deviation from the budgeted standard. In the case of direct materials, there are two reasons why we might have a budget variance. First, we might have a material price variance, which is caused when the actual material purchase price is different from the standard price. Maybe each pound of materials was budgeted to cost $5, but the company ended up paying something higher or lower, creating the variance. Second, we might have a material quantity variance, which is caused when the actual amount of direct materials used does not match the standard amount of materials allowed. Maybe there were some mistakes in production, causing more materials to be used than was initially planned, creating the variance. In other words, the $1,000 unfavorable material cost variance in our example can actually be broken apart into a price variance component and a quantity variance component. Let's say that higher prices than anticipated contributed to $200 of the unfavorable variance, and material waste contributed to the other $800 of the variance, which totals to the $1,000 total unfavorable direct materials variance. Let's look at how you would calculate the direct materials price and quantity variances with an example. Let's say that Ellison Enterprises is producing picnic tables, and in this period they purchased and used 10,000 boards to produce 540 tables. The company was able to pay $1.40 per board, although their standard costing system suggests that boards should cost $1.50 each. The standard costing system also budgets that each picnic table requires 18 boards to produce. Our goal is to calculate the total direct materials variance and to determine how that variance is split between the price and quantity variances. I'm going to start by calculating a few different numbers. First is the actual cost of materials or boards that were purchased, which can be found by taking the actual quantity of materials purchased times the actual price paid. We abbreviate AQ for actual quantity and AP for actual price. We have 10,000 boards, which is our actual quantity, times the $1.40 actual price paid per board, which equals $14,000. Some problems will give you the actual cost, meaning you won't even need to do this calculation, so watch out for that. The next thing we want to calculate is the actual quantity, AQ, times the standard price, SP. The actual quantity of materials purchased is still 10,000 boards, but now we are multiplying by the standard price of $1.50 per board, which gives us $15,000. Now I want you to notice the difference between the two quantities that we've calculated. Both values use the actual quantity, but one multiplies by the actual price, and one multiplies by the standard price. In other words, we have held quantity constant and allowed only price to vary. When we let only price vary, we get the price variance when we subtract these two values. 14,000 minus 15,000 equals a $1,000 price variance. We don't write negative or positive signs, but instead we label the variance as favorable or unfavorable. You can verify that this variance is favorable by examining the prices. The $1.40 purchase price is lower than the standard price of $1.50, so the company got a good deal on materials, which creates the favorable variance. Next, we need to calculate the standard cost, which is equal to the standard quantity, SQ, times the standard price, SP. The standard quantity is the amount of materials that should have been used to create the number of units that were produced. The standard quantity can be found by taking the 18 boards per table multiplied by the 540 tables produced, which equals 9,720 boards. This can be multiplied by the $1.50 standard price per board to get $14,580 as our standard cost. We are trying to calculate the quantity variance now, meaning we must hold the price constant. You should notice that these two values both multiply by the standard price, keeping price constant, but the quantity changes from actual to standard. That means that the difference between these two values is the direct materials quantity variance, which comes to $420 unfavorable. Why unfavorable? Well, because the company used 10,000 boards when the budget suggests that only 9,720 boards should have been used. If you have set up your problem exactly how I have, here's a quick and easy way to determine if the variances are favorable or unfavorable. Increasing from left to right suggests a favorable variance, and decreasing from left to right suggests an unfavorable variance. For example, from $14,000 to $15,000 is an increase, which makes the price variance favorable. From $15,000 to $14,580 is a decrease, making the quantity variance unfavorable. Finally, we can calculate the total direct materials variance by subtracting the price and quantity variances. We subtract them because one is favorable and the other is unfavorable, otherwise we would add them together. $1,000 minus $420 equals a $580 total direct material variance, which is favorable. When one variance is favorable and the other is unfavorable, the total variance has the same label as the larger variance. In this case, the $1,000 favorable price variance. We can apply standard costing to direct labor cost as well. Here's the slide we used before when we introduced the materials variances. We will change the labels so that they are appropriate for labor variances. Instead of materials being purchased, we now have labor being purchased in the form of an hourly rate that's being paid to our workers. Labor costs will also have a budgeted standard to which there can be deviations from, creating variances. Let's let the budget be larger than the actual labor costs, creating a $1,000 favorable variance this time. The $10,000 of labor costs are less than the $11,000 budget, which is why the variance is favorable. Instead of a material price variance, we have a labor rate variance, which is caused when the actual labor rate is different from the standard rate. So if we had to pay our employees a higher wage rate due to overtime work, that might cause a labor rate variance. Instead of a material quantity variance, we have a labor efficiency variance, which is caused when the actual amount of labor hours used does not match the standard number of hours allowed. So if our employees were efficient and produced the required number of units with plenty of hours to spare, that would create a labor efficiency variance. In this case, let's assume that the company has a $200 favorable rate variance, meaning that they paid their employees a little bit less than the budgeted hourly wage rate. And let's assume there is an $800 favorable efficiency variance, meaning that the employees didn't need to work quite as many hours as budgeted to produce the required number of units. These two values add up to our $1,000 favorable direct labor variance. Now let's look at how you would calculate the direct labor rate and efficiency variances in an example. Continuing with the same example we used for the direct materials variances, Ellison Enterprises is producing picnic tables, and in this period, the workers worked for 1,100 hours to produce 540 tables. The company paid an hourly rate of $16 per hour, although their standard costing system budgets the hourly rate at $15 per hour. The standard costing system also budgets that each picnic table requires 2 direct labor hours to produce. Our goal is to calculate the total direct labor variance and to determine how that variance is split between the rate and efficiency variances. If you understood the direct material price and quantity variances, the labor rate and efficiency variances are almost identical. We just need to make small adjustments in the terminology. Instead of a price per unit of material, we have an hourly rate. Instead of a quantity of materials that were used, we have the number of direct labor hours that were worked. With that being said, the actual cost of direct labor can be found by taking the actual number of hours of labor used times the actual hourly rate. We abbreviate AH for actual hours and AR for actual rate. We have 1,100 actual hours times the $16 actual rate paid per hour, which equals $17,600. The next thing we want to calculate is the actual hours, AH, times the standard rate, SR. The actual hours of labor used is still 1,100 hours, but now we are multiplying by the standard rate of $15 per hour, which gives us $16,500. Now I want you to notice the difference between the two quantities we have calculated. Both values use the actual hours, but one multiplies by the actual rate, and one multiplies by the standard rate. In other words, we have held hours constant and allowed only the rate to vary. When we let only the rate vary, we get the rate variance when we subtract the two values. 16,500 minus 17,600 is equal to a $1,100 unfavorable rate variance. You can verify that this variance is unfavorable by examining the rates. The $16 actual rate is higher than the standard rate of $15. This might be favorable for the employees, but it is unfavorable to the company from a budgeting perspective. You can also tell that the variance is unfavorable by noticing that the values decrease as you go from left to right. Next, we need to calculate the standard cost, which is equal to the standard hours, SH, times the standard rate, SR. The standard hours are the amount of hours that should have been used to create the number of picnic tables that were produced. The standard hours can be found by taking the standard of 2 hours per table multiplied by the 540 tables produced, which equals 1,080. This can be multiplied by the $15 standard rate per hour to get $16,200. We are trying to calculate the efficiency variance now, which relates to the hours used, meaning that we must hold the rate constant. You should notice that these two values both multiply by the standard rate, keeping rate constant, but the hours change from actual to standard. That means that the difference between these two values is the direct labor efficiency variance, which comes to $300 unfavorable. Why unfavorable? Well, because the company used 1,100 hours of direct labor when the budget suggests that only 1,080 hours should have been used. $1,100 plus $300 is equal to $1,400 of total direct labor variance, which is unfavorable as each of the individual variances were also unfavorable. Alright, that wraps up our example on direct labor variances for standard costing. I will be creating 2 additional videos where I will complete standard costing overhead variances, as well as the journal entries related to standard costing. So make sure to watch those videos if those topics are covered in your class.